here they come. Carrera in their all red strip, and New Zealand this evening in the white. It's a fascinating game in prospect here. An on-form Korea are always a tough opponent, and if they keep up the form of yesterday, then they could give New Zealand a real run for their money here in this one. So blue skies overhead, the sun shining down on the turf here, and I'm delighted to say that once again sitting alongside me is Todd Williams. Todd, welcome again. And I know that you, like me, are looking forward to this one.
Yes, yeah, there's a lot of interest in this, isn't there? We've got New Zealand, who are currently undefeated. Elms here making a first effort towards the circle.
Good fluid movement here from the New Zealanders.
Yeah, good work from Korea to get numbers back, though. Still,
this is silky smooth from the New Zealanders, and a great finish as well at the end of it. Lovely flowing move. It started in their own half of the field and ends with a shot high into the Korean net.
Well, this is a lovely, lovely goal. As you say, flowing is the word to describe it. It looked like a quick counter-attack, and then Elms at the last moment decided just to pull back and work the other side, which was a very, very sorry, it was Holbrook, I think, which was a very, very sensible decision to make. And can I just say, Nick, that Scott Boyd's last two shots at goal, I think he'd be particularly happy with. Yesterday was a stunning reverse stick upright.
As New Zealand look to extend their lead and give themselves just a little bit of wriggle room in the game. Charles sets himself again. I thought he got up a bit quickly from the last one. Maybe he'll stay a little lower this time. Good routine, good save, but well, no chance with the follow up there. Keeper did really well with the first one.
Kane Russell, almost like a basketballer here, picking up his own rebound. It's almost though he's played that off Yehun Kim's shoe, knowing exactly that it was coming back to him. We see it here, he's onto it. There's the flick, bang, straight back to him. And from there, a relatively simple finish. Once he's controlled it as well as he has, you see there, those first two runners, they're out of the loop. Thanks very much.
Wide open spaces on the left. And there's no reprieve this time for Korea. Once again, the initial shot is saved, but the follow-up puts it high beyond the flailing goalkeeper. And a dream start to the second half here for New Zealand.
Yeah, Jake Smith with the simplest of finishes. That goal comes from a wonderful pass from Kane Russell to find Simon Child, who first of all controls it really well, then has the composure to work his way into a shot, puts it across, and then, oh, a bit of misfortune there.
Keeper makes half a save and is punished. Well, New Zealand are very adept at starting quarters so well, Todd, aren't they?
Yeah, they
not a bad habit.
Certainly are, and this is created by fabulous play by Sean Finlay down the left. Finds Inglis at the top of the circle. Not surprisingly, Inglis does everything you should do in that situation, in so much that he puts the ball on the target, creates the rebound, and it's Isaac Holbrook who's in the right spice, right place at the right time.
Just to remind our viewers, the team that wins this Nation Cup gets the invitation from the Federation of International Hockey to join the Pro League. And Korea get one back there and race the ball back to the halfway line. Are we going to see a major upset? Well, Korea, it's good to see they've not given up hope yet. Cheonlon Park again with the tapping goal there.
Yeah, and for all the reasons we've just been talking about, that's an important goal for Korea. 8 minutes to go, brings them back to within two goals, so they're still in the game, but more importantly, it's finishing the game as this young team.
Yes. And that is the final action in our opening game of the day here, match 11 in this FIH Hockey Men's Nation Cup here in Gniezno in Poland has ended with a New Zealand victory over Korea by 4-2. And so New Zealand complete their pool matches, played 4-1-4, and a goal difference of +8. Korea still have one game to play. Their points tally remains at 3. The same as Poland and Austria, who are on 3 at the moment. And an exciting, entertaining game. New Zealand always in the pound seats in terms of getting a result. And they certainly had the uncanny knack of starting each quarter with an early goal to make it very difficult indeed for Korea to ever really get within range. Great credit though to Korea for keep going in what was an open and game played in excellent spirit. Well handled by two more than handy umpires with little or no recourse to video today. Rather nice change of things. There's confirmation of the scoreline for you. New Zealand 4, Korea 2.